zuru to serve with resoluteness to make this clan a land of righteousness.
Jama hasalam alaikum hinakwa nanku inagejia dig indikake. Jama muna geshika inakwa na inagejia sobo de loko chi badaya bani. Ko wani lokaci muna fito muku da wannan tunani ezo na a zuciyanka domin ka tabbatar Allah baba ne, Allah baba ne, Allah mai girma ne, Allah yana ina ko ina ne, Allah ne yayi duniya da karfin sa. Jama'a muna ga maka wannan domin kai ka gane ka ci gaba da jin tsoron Allah, saboda ba abun da yafi Allah a duniya da karfin ka da ikon ka da ilimin ka da komai da komai da kudin ka. Allah ya fi karfin ka, kuma ya kamata kana ji tsoron sa kowane lokaci. Duba baban duniya inda yake, Allah ne yayi shi a hannunsa, shi yayi sa. Jama'a kana barci yanzu, maiwa kana tashi, maiwa kana rana, wannan suna shi dabam ne, ikon Allah kenan. Shi yasa kowane lokaci zamu fito mu yi maka irin wannan tunani a Radio Biafra na Hausa Service na biyu, inda wannan magana yake zuwa maka jama'a. Mun fito kuma domin mu tabbatar mu yi abin da ya kamata a yi, abin da ya kamata mutum ya yi, abin da ya kamata mu ma mu yi jama'a. Mun fita domin mu yi mai domin mu tona asiri wanda ya kamata a tona musu asiri gaba daya. Jama'a mun fito domin a fada gaskiya, wannan magana wanda an kifa da wannan magana wanda baya so a fada, mun fito domin a fada shi. Why ne wanda zai hana mu maganan gaskiya? Kai zunubi, kai zunubi kana koye shi, yanzu Allah ya fito da baki wanda zai fada wannan abun. Jama'a shi yasa muna nan, mun zo domin mu taimake ka, ke wanda ba mai ji murenka, ke ba wanda zai tose maka, ke wanda ba an hana ka yi maganan gaskiya, ke wanda ana hana haske ya shigo maka. Jama'a mun zo domin mu taimaka maka. Ai mu ne Radio Biafra, Radio Biafra na Hausa Service na biyu, wannan magana yake zuwa maka daga ni. Sunan mai taimako mai gidanmu sunan shi Mazi Uche Mefo, kuma mai gidanmu sunan shi Mazi Inandi Kano, muna kira shi Ohamadike. Shi ne shugaban kasan dan Biafra gaba daya duk inda kake, kuma shi ne director namu a Radio Biafra da television dinsa. Kuma magana ike zuwa maka a gurin na aini almajiri Mazi Inandi Kano, sunana Nwachineke. Kafin mu ci gaba, bari mu yi addu'a tukuna. Ubangiji Allah, mun gode maka da abubuwan da kana yi mana, mun gode maka kowane lokaci, sai mun gode maka Ubangiji, saboda da ranmu ai ba da karfin mu bane, ba da kokarin mu bane, muna nan da rai da lafiya, ke ne mai barwa. Shi yasa muna gode maka kowane lokaci, sai mun gode maka Allah. Kuma muna roke ka da wadansu abubuwa, Ubangiji Allah ka taimaka mana, ka yi mana albarka, ka taimaka mana Ubangiji Allah. Ga kasan mu Biafra, muna roke ka ka taimaka mana mu samu kasan mu, domin mu zoma a duniya inda mutum ya kamata ya zona, Ubangiji Allah. Kuma muna roke ka akan gidanmu Mazi Inandi Kano, ina roke ka ka yi mushi albarka duk inda yake, Ubangiji Allah ka yi mushi albarka, ka tabbatar hannun masu bakin zunubi be same shi ba duk inda yake, Ubangiji Allah ka taimaka mushi, ka bashi ilimi, ka bashi duk abubuwan da yake so akan wannan aiki da ka kira mu muyi. Ga kuma munan su mutanen mu a Biafra inda suke shan waya wanda nyuwa yake damu wanansu, muna roke ka Ubangiji Allah ka taimaka mana, ka yi abun da kai ka dai zaka yi, ka yi wannan abun wanda kai ka dai za yi a kansu, kowa da kowa, domin su tabbatar su samu alheri, su samu albarka, kuma su gane wai kai ne Allah mai yi wannan abun. Ina roke ka a sunan Yesu Almasihu mai ceto, Amen. To jamaa yo muna de wana su abubuwa wanda zamu ye. Ama kafumu chikaba. Na so ndanyi wani magana kadang. Sobo de yo. Munzo mu yi wazi akang. Shira shiramu. Na. What na. Lokochin. Talating. Awannan water. Lokochin. Hari talating. Awannan water. Muna kira 30th May. Kowani shekara muna yi wannan bincike da mun mutuna wannan sun mutane wanda aka kashe lokacin Biafran war kowa ya san abin da ya faru a lokacin in the Nigerian government the British government the duniya gabaɗaya suke takura mana suke takura mutanen mu suke rike mana suke hana mana har ma cin abinci ahana mana aka kashe mana mutum kusan million biyar da rabi aka kashe lokacin ba wanda yake maganan su sai da lokacin Allah ya kira mu mu fito shi yasa muke maganan su kowani shekara a wata biyar a ranan 30 dole ne mu tana da su dole ne mu yi abin da ana kira remembrance day akan su jama'a wannan abubuwa zamu yi yo amma kafin mu ci gaba akwai abun da ina so mu dan san hannu kadan jama'a akwai wani labari wanda ina so in karanta an ce Sokoto gunmen kill over 60 people in 3 villages resident flee home we masu bundiga sunan su masu bundiga we sun kashe mutum wanda ya fi 16 mutum wanda yafi 16 dubu 16 mutum wanda yafi 16 an kashe su yanzu a Sokoto Sokoto wanda ka san gidan sultan na Sokoto a garin sa ana yi wannan bincike ana yi wannan kashe kashe yanzu jama'a over 60 people were killed on Wednesday night when some gunmen attack Garki, Katuma, and the Kuzari village under Sabumbrini local government area of Sokoto State. Those who sustain life-threatening injuries are currently receiving treatment at General Hospital Sabumbrini, according to the resident who spoke with Sahara Report. And when Abun Yafaru, kwana biyu wanda ya wuce da dare kuma suka shigo wannan garin da aka fada sunan sa Sabon Birni local government sun je wajen suka kashe mutane we wanda suka samu wannan su ciwo yanzu suna asibiti ana ba su treatment inji daga Sahara Report ne nike karanta wannan abun the number of the people that died may rise as more corpses are being deposited at the mortuary of Sabumbrini General Hospital. It was discovered. When wannan mutane wanda suke mutu me waze fi wannan lamba wanda aka fada saboda ana tapito de wannan su gawan mutum ana tapito de gawan mutum har yanzu jama'a kuma kasin a Nigeria ba a fada gaskiya idan an ce maka dari ka kara shi kaman 200 ko 3 haka abun da ya faru a wajen me wa wannan local government wanda ana kiriya Sabon Birni a Sokoto me wa yanzu wannan gunmen sun gama da su gabaɗaya sun kankare su sun kashe kowa da kowa a wajen amma za ce mana mutum kusan 16 da wani abu kiriya a Nigeria kenan the number of people that died may rise as more corpses are being deposited at the mortuary of the Sabon Birni General Hospital it was discovered to mene san wannan abun frequent attack by gunmen across the local government area has forced hundreds of people to flee their villages on Monday 18 people were killed another attack at Faji Langjew Kadeya at wannan local government kuma about 15 to 20 kilometers from Sabumbrini town. Wannan su kuma aka kashe ranan Monday. Akwai wannan su wanda aka kashe ranan Monday. Kuma wannan abun ya sa masu gering ne suna gudu yanzu sun bar gering su suna gudu su nema wani wuri inda za su je. Some residents of the affected village allege that some of the armed attackers were herders who used the occasion as they respond to farmers' efforts to prevent them from destroying their farm by grazing their herds. Wannan abun ne masu kiwon shanu ne, masu kiwon shanu saboda suna kan fada da masu gona, so yanzu suke tashi nasu da wuri, sun tashi da wuri domin kare wannan mutane su hana su wannan abun. Kuma wannan abun ya faru kilometer 15 zuwa kilometer 20 kusa da wannan garin Birnin town wajen da wannan abun ya faru. Since the beginning of this year, a growing number of residents in Sabon Birnin local government area fled their home, while those who had stayed back had formed a vigilante group to protect their community. Wannan su mutane a wannan local government sun gudu sun bar gari, sun shigo cikin gari yanzu. Wannan su kuma sun fara aikin yambanga a wajen, suna gadi garin su kasan su, wai bar su tashi ba jama'a. Wannan abun ya faru a Sokoto, wannan abun ya faru a garin Sultan na Sokoto. Har yanzu ba mu ji maganan sa, har yanzu ba mu ji maganan sa, muna kan jira mu ji abun da shi ma zai fada jama'a. Abun da yake faru a Nigeria ai mamaki ne yake ba motani, wallahi tallahi ba abun gaskiya, ba cin gaba, sai kashi kashe mutane. Ga kuma ana fada ana giya wannan su ku tashi ku koye bayan mu, a tabbatar abun da za yi domin abu yayi maka kyau kai kuma kaki. Wani lokaci sai ka gani kana gani abu wai abun ba fara ne, gashi kuma ana ta kashe ka. Ya dade ina fada a nan radio ina giya muku, idan baka tashi da wuri ka bi gaskiya, lokacin da abun zai dawo, wallahi tallahi inda zai same ka, inda zai same ka barkaci dadin sa kodaya. To gashi inda aka kashe mutane a banza, kwanakin bayan kashe yau kuma an kashe, gobe za a kashe, domin kar a kashe ka yanzu ka tashi inda kake, ka giya musu wai wannan Nigeria ya an mun gaji da shi a raba kawai, wai muna koyan bayan mutanen Biafra IPOB na mazi Nnamdi Kanu, wai abun da muke so. Saboda jama'a kuna ji, idan aka raba kasan aka ba ku shugaban kasa asalin dan kasan ku su shigo suna yi muku miliki, wane ne shine masu kiwon shanu, wane ne Boko Haram wanda zai zo yi muku irin wannan abun, shi waye ne, daga ina zai zo, daga ina zai tashi, waye ne ya haife sa? Saboda kuna da shugaban kasa, kuna da shugaban kasa wanda shi asalin dan wanku, wallahi. To ga kuma na biyu, amma bari mu kwata lokaci akan wannan abun. Wai gwamnatin Buhari ya rubuta ma House of Reps, wai shi kuma yana so a sake aja a karba kudi, aron kudi aja ci bashi biliyon biyar da rabi. Buhari yake so ya zo ya karbo a dola. Kuma Buhari writes House of Reps seek fresh loan of 5.513 billion. Jama'a wane daga ina za a biya wannan kudi? Nigeria suna da kudi ne, ba kudin, amma ga ka ana ta karbo kudi, baka magana an sal da kanka, ka zo na wajen kawai, ba abun da yake faru, ba abun da zai faru, amma ga kai ana sal da kai a hankali, a ina za samu wannan kudi jama'a da zai biya? Ana sa zuciya a cikin kudin mai da kana za zuciyansa, yenze dinne abasa so mai idemba mai ba ka giama na in the Nigeria zasu Jesus samu kudin da zasu biya wannan bashi a duniya babu san sir da kai ana so ayi kuma wannan halin Fulani ne. Fulani bara su giya maka abun da suke so su yi da farko amma zasu ci gaba da su yi abun da suna so su yi a hankali zasu dinga yi sotes lokacin da zasu dawo akan wannan abun. To ga inda ana kashe mutane a banza yan kasan Nigeria yanzu an fara rereregen su gaba daya daga Sokoto zuwa Kudu aikin su daga Sokoto zuwa Kudu yanzu aikin su ana tarege su duk inda suke jama'a. Wannan abun bai kamata ba. Idan kana da tunani yanzu ne zaka tashi kayime ka zo ka koye baya abun da muke giya muku ka zo ka koye bayan mu ka tabbatar maganan da muke yi maka ka koye bayan mu saboda wanda ya faru ya riga ya faru kuma wanda yake so ya faru bare faru ba. Amma idan ka ishiru ka zona mai wake ka ce kai musulmi ne kana fama da Fulani wai ku adinin ku daya ne ko yaya ne ko ya dade kuna zona tare wallahi tallahi ka jira lokacinka a lokaci kadan za zo a same ka a wajen jama'a a lokaci kadan za zo a same ka kuma abun da zai faru baka da baki da zaka yi magana anan za mu siya maganan mu na yo saboda muna da wannan su abubuwa wanda zamu yi akan shirashiranmu akan abun da muke yi jama'a. So gobe kuma zamu ci gaba da wannan su abubuwa amma a lokaci kadan hanyar mu zai bude idan ya bude zaka iya kiriya mu ka zo kuma ka yi magana jama'a. Assalamu alaikum. This is Radio Biafra Hausa Service 2 coming to you from the platform of Radio Biafra London, being deputized by the good man himself, Mazi Uchemefo, under the leadership of one and only Onyendu Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. He is the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra and he's the director of Radio Biafra and her television. And this message is coming to you from me, a servant of the Most High, a servant of the indigenous people of Biafra, and a proud disciple of our leader in the person of Nwachineke. We are back despite one or two things. We are still back. We are live and direct right now. Just in a summary, I was discussing something that happened in Sokoto, the number of people that have been killed by gunmen. According to the report I read from Sahara Reporter News, they said that 60 people had been confirmed dead. And out of these 60 people, the other ones, they are still recovering some of their corpses from the bushes where they have been massacred by the so-called gunmen. This is what is happening. And this is a warning to us towards the east to wake up now. Because the Sokoto people, the Hausa people, the Cape Mut, they allow them to enter and they have entered. Now they can't help themselves. They are everywhere and they can do whatever they wish to do. This is a warning to the people from the South, mostly from the Yoruba Axis, who are playing politics over what is happening. We also talk about Buhari being want to borrow another $5.513 billion. He want to borrow again. People should rise up before you've been sold while you are alive, because Africa is very foolish. But that is not what we have for today. Today we are in continuation of our program the day before yesterday. We are in continuation of it because this is the preparation of 30th May, and prayer had been given to us to do in order not to waste much of our time, because off and on of our system has made us to waste some certain time. Our line will be open right now. You can call in. We are still reading the psalm. Today we continue from Psalm 120. We continue from Psalm 120. You can call in continuation of the psalm. You can call in. You can get us with this number, +18326373499. I repeat, +18326373499. You can call in and read the psalm as we are preparing for the celebration for our Heroes Day for the 30th May, in remembrance of those who fall. But I want to make this very clear. While you are calling, I would like you to come with a name. You must mention one name of the heroes that fall, one of them. You just share briefly who he is, maybe a little things you know about him. Then you continue with your reading. That is how I want to put it here. Don't call while you don't know anybody or you don't have anybody. I remember years back, as a Catholic, sorry for our Catholic brothers, I'm just using it as an example. I used to read about so many Catholic saints, you know, saint this, saint that, saint this, you know. But at the time, while one were growing up, I now discovered that these people, as they have been tagged saint, these are war generals, people that went to war. They fought, they came back, you know, from the time of Constantine till then, till today. Maybe depend how you fought and whatever, and maybe wake up with a dream. Then they will tag you a saint. You will be canonized by your people, and the people will go to church and be praying to this saint to pray to God for them. I'm not castigating your belief or whatever, but I'm telling you how that thing come into being, you know. So we will not castigate ours. Those who fought for us are very good people. The highest thing one can give to you presently is to use his life as a sacrifice to go and defend you while you are somewhere, while you are born or unborn yet. That person is the highest saint, if you don't know. So you must recognize them. You must remember. Look for a name before you call the radio. You say, so person, Philip Efiong, he is this. Then you will be permitted. This is how I want to put it here. This man, this brave man, they fought gallantly for us to live, even though they did not succeed. Even though they didn't succeed, we all know, and God has revealed all these things for us, and our leader is following it. That is why a day like this, there is fasting, there is prayer, and all manner of things being given for us to follow to make sure that Biafra comes, and Biafra will come on our time. Biafra will come on our time. So I will begin the reading from reading Psalm 120. Then when you call in, you can take in from Psalm 121. This is Radio Biafra Absa Service 2. And I read, I took my trouble to the Lord. I cried out to him, and he answered my prayer. Rescue me, O Lord, from liars and from all deceitful people. A deceptive tongue, what will God do to you? How will he increase your punishment?
You will be pierced with sharp arrows and burned with glowing coals. How I suffer in fire of Mesek. It pains me to live in distant Kedar. I am tired of living among people who hate peace. I search for peace, but when I speak of peace, they want war. This is Psalm 120. The writer of this psalm is a good man. He has a good heart, looking for peace. The writer is like one of us, is like you and I, who want to be free from the wicked ones. As far as we are concerned, Nigeria is a very wicked country, and the people who love her so much are wicked. We must know that it's a very wicked country, destroying the people of the Most High. For my sharing this morning, I will take it from the book of Joshua, chapters number 6. How the walls of Jericho fall down. How the walls of Jericho fall down. Because there is another wall of Jericho that is about to fall down, and that wall is the Zoological Republic of Nigeria. The walls of Jericho of Zoological Republic of Nigeria, the country Zoological Republic of Nigeria has done worse, even more than this Jericho we are about to read. So what will make it not to fall? If God will destroy such country, why won't Zoo be destroyed again? And I read from chapter 6. Now the gate of Jericho were tightly shut, because the people were afraid of Israelite. No one was allowed to go out or in. But the Lord said to Joshua, I have given you Jericho, its kings, and all its strong warrior. You and your fighting men should march around the town once a day for 6 days. 7 priests will walk ahead of the ark, each carrying a ram's horn. On the 7th day, you are to march around the town 7 times with the priest blowing the horn. When you hear the priest, give one loud blast on the ram's horn. Have all the people shout as loud as they can. Then the wall of the town will collapse, and the people can charge straight into the town. 6. So Joshua called together the priests and said, take up the ark of the Lord's covenant and assign 7 priests to walk in front of it, each carrying a ram's horn. Then he gave order to the people, march around the town, and the armed men will lead the way in front of the ark of the Lord. After Joshua spoke to the people, the 7 priests with the ram's horn started marching in the presence of the Lord, blowing the horns as they march. And the ark of the Lord's covenant followed behind them. Some of the armed men marched in front of the priests with the horn, and some behind the ark, with the priests continuing blowing the horn. Do not shout. Do not even talk, Joshua commanded. Not a single word from any of you until I tell you to shout. Then shout. So the ark of the Lord was carried around the town once that day, and then everyone returned to spend the night in the camp. Joshua got up the next morning, and the priests again carried the ark of the Lord. 7 priests with the ram's horn marched in front of the ark of the Lord, blowing their horns. Again, the armed men marched both in front of the priests with the horn and behind the ark of the Lord. All this time, the priests were blowing their horn. On the 2nd day, They again marched around the town once and turned to the camp. They followed this pattern for 6 days. On the seventh day, the Israelites got up at the dawn and marched round the town as they had done before, but this time they went around the town 7 times. The seventh time around, as the priests sounded the long blast on their horn, Joshua commanded the people, "Shout, for the Lord has given you the town. Jericho and everything in it must be completely destroyed as an offering to the Lord. Only Rahab, the prostitute, and the others in her household will be spared, for she protected our spies. Do not take any of the things set apart for destruction, or you yourself will be completely destroyed. You will bring trouble on the camp of Israel. Everything made of silver, gold, bronze, or iron is sacred to the Lord and must be brought into his treasury." When the people heard the sound of the ram's horn, they shouted as loud as they could. Suddenly, the walls of Jericho collapsed, and the Israelites charged straight into the town and captured it. They completely destroyed everything in it with their sword. Men and women, young and old, cattle, sheep, goat, and donkey. Meanwhile, Joshua said to the two spies, "Keep your promise. Go to the prostitute house and bring her out along with all her family." The men who had been spies went in and brought out Rahab, her father, mother, brothers, and all other relatives who were with her. They moved her whole family to a safe place near the camp of Israel. Then the Israelites burned the town and everything in it. Only the things made of silver, gold, bronze, or iron were kept for the treasury of the Lord's house. So Joshua spread Rahab, the prostitute, and her relatives who were with her in the house, because she had hidden the spy Joshua sent to Jericho, and she lives among the Israelites to this day. At that time, Joshua invoked this curse: "May the curse of the Lord fall on anyone who tried to rebuild the town of Zoological Republic of Nigeria at the cost of his firstborn son. He will lay the foundation at the cost of his youngest son. He will set up his gate." So the Lord was with Joshua, and his reputation spread throughout the land. This is how the walls of Jericho were destroyed, and this is how the Zoological Republic of Nigeria is going to destroy at this time. We must understand what we are doing, because it's a spiritual thing. All we are doing is spiritual. We are not doing on our own. We are being led by the Spirit of the Most High to do what we are doing. Our leader is a prophet, confirmed one. He has the gift, and he is leading his people. This year, he's the one that asks you to pray. He's the one that asks us to fast. You must follow the instruction. Look at what happened here. Look at what exactly happens here. Joshua told the people what to do, and they followed the instruction. Wake up early in the morning, take the Ark of the Lord's Covenant, take the ram's horn, and begin to blow it and move around the town of Jericho. And there was no question. He said, "Don't utter a word. Do what I ask you to do. Don't say anything until I ask you to do." This is instruction, and this is what we must follow. And by doing it, the first day, the second day, the third day, till the seventh day, they moved around the walls of Jericho 7 times, and Elohim himself fought the battle for his people. The God we are serving, Chukwuka Kabiama, is a God of principle, and he would like you to obey him at all time. Is a God that will want you to obey him whatever he asks you to do. Any instruction given to you, you must follow it. And that is how breakthrough can come in. People of God, we must understand all those things. We must follow the instruction. The Zoological Republic of Nigeria has dealt with people. Every day it is killing, and no mercy, no remedy. Rather, they allow the killing to continue so that they will achieve their aim. How can Fulani be moving about killing people, massacring people, and the so-called leaders don't care? How can such a thing be going on and nobody cares about the lives of people? Why won't God destroy Zoological Republic? Is a question one can ask. Why won't the Zoological Republic destroyed with the people that are following, with the people that want it to be in that way? Nigeria must go down. Nigeria must be destroyed. The anger of God supposed to be burning upon the zoo, and this is the time. And I believe that after this celebration, great things is going to happen. The Most High indeed will destroy that country by himself. Because the way the blood of the innocent have been flowed, been shed on the street, as if human being is no more anything, is too much. That is the wickedness of the wicked. It's not even to compare to the wickedness of the people of Jericho as at that time. Their own is that they don't want Israel to pass. But that of the zoo don't want us to pass. And the zoo itself are killing people. You see why that of the zoo will be doubled, will be multiplied. It doesn't matter their soldiers. It doesn't matter what they are sending down. Listen, when we follow the rules and regulations, when we keep the laws and commandments of the Most High, when we do what he asks us to do from his prophet, definitely victory will be ours. One thing God loves is for you to obey his instruction. One thing God wants is for you to do that which he has ordered you to do. In doing it, allow the rest of the job to be done. The walls of Jericho was the highest in the whole planet. Who are you to break in? That is why Jericho was one of the strongest nations as at that time. But indeed, God Almighty understands that. He proved to them that indeed, I am the creator of the heaven and the earth. Everything is in my hand. I can destroy and I can create. According to Isaiah 47. He can destroy and he can create. He just passed the instruction to his own people to see if they will obey, if they will follow. And indeed, they anchored to the word of the prophet. Every morning, wake up. Let the priest carry the Ark of the Covenant. With the soldiers moving and other Levites blowing the ram's horn, moving around the temple. Other people should not talk when you are asked not to talk. Keep on doing it the first day. Nobody questioned. But look at our time these days. Some people will just question. Somebody will do this. Some won't even believe. Some won't even follow. The things of God, sometimes it looks foolishly. It sounds so stupid. But that is what we are asked to do. Because carnal mind cannot understand the spiritual things. On the first day, there are some carnal people in the camp of Israel that may not understand what these people are doing. They will look at carnally, just as what we are doing now. As our leader has told us what to do, most of us may not. Some won't even pray. Some won't even fast. Some won't even believe what we are doing. That is where the problem lies. But if the number needed can do this, I'm telling you, definitely, you will hear what will be happening. Because as at now, as a rock is empty, you have been hearing it. Our leader has been trying his best to make sure that the latest revelation comes out, latest news comes out, to open the eyes of people, to understand that indeed, Elohim is at work. Any person that will go and replace, let that person wait for his death. He removed Buhari, Abba Kyari put himself, he falls. Let another person go in, he himself will fall. Because according to the book of Joshua here, where we read, it said, curse be upon anyone who will rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Anything the Lord has removed, the curse will fall upon anyone who is trying to rest. It's just like the zoo. Just like some of you who are trying to, who are clamoring for one zoological republic. Don't let the curse of God be upon you. Don't let the anger of God be upon you. Because you are trying to fix what God is destroying. It is like you fighting with the nature. It is like you stopping the rain from falling. It's like you stopping the sun from rising. You are wasting your time. You will destroy yourself by yourself. Those of you who don't want to be part and parcel of the fight, you have seen everything. Look at what is going on. You're supposed to know that indeed this is the finger of God. This is the hand of God working. This is the hand of God destroying the zoo gradually, giving them signal for everybody to take time. Still, some of us are still there, putting their head. There will be no sorry for you when you have been destroyed like the walls of Jericho. Because while the walls of Jericho was going down, it goes down with heads of people. We must understand. This is Radio Biafra Hausa Service 2. You can call in now for the reading of the Psalms. But before you call in, make sure you come in with a name. Just as I have said, please come in with a name of one of the heroes that have fallen. You tell us the one you love so much, or the one you want to be your role model. You know, you tell about him, then you start reading from Psalm 120. You can call in with this number now, +1 833 263 73 499. +1 833 263 73 499. This is in preparation of our 30th meme that is coming up tomorrow. Everybody must prepare. Everybody must get ready. We must remember them. We must remember them. That is the highest price one can pay for you, to lay down his life, to risk his life, to go for war for you, to live, for the land to be okay. They are the highest saint. Not those ones sometimes you bow down in some certain denominational churches. I'm not against church, but I'm against one or two things church are doing. You bow down and you pray to them, and these people are not indigenous to you. You need to pray to the people that are indigenous to you, that are good men. We have sent. And these war generals, these people that went and fight for you and I, they are our own sent of our own time. Because they laid their life for you and I to live. There's no white man that will die for you. You must have that in mind. Look at what is happening in the world. You're supposed to use it to understand who is who. Supposed to understand who is who. Before they fight for you, there must be an interest. They are fighting for something. Before you see any nation that will rise up to fight for you, there must be an interest. So let us not waste much of our time on discussing the issue. This is Radio Biafra Hausa Service 2, coming to you from the platform of Radio Biafra London. You can call in now for your Psalms reading.
Chineke mera nyaka. Thrones of the house of David. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. They shall prosper that love thee. Peace be within thy walls, and prosperity within thy palace. For my brethren and my companions' sake, I will not say, peace be within thee. Because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek thy good. Psalm 123. Unto thee lift I up my eyes, and thou that dwellest in the heavens. Behold, as the eyes of the servant look unto the hands of his master, and as the eyes of a maiden look up to the hands of her mistress, so our eyes wait upon the Lord our God, until that he have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, O Lord. Have mercy upon us. For we are exceedingly filled with contempt. Our soul is exceedingly filled with the scorning of those that are at ease, and with the contempt of the proud. Psalm 124. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, now may Jerusalem say, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, when men rose up against us, then they had swallowed us up all quick. Then their wrath was kindled against us. Then the water had overwhelmed us. The stream had gone over our souls. Then the proud waters had gone over our souls. Blessed be the Lord who had not given us as a prey to their teeth. Our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowler. The snare is broken, and we are escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and the earth. Psalm 121. They that trust in the Lord shall be as Mount Zion, that cannot be removed, but abideth forever. As the mountains are round about Jerusalem, so the Lord is round about his people from henceforth even forever. For the rod of the wicked shall not rest upon the lot of the righteous. Lest the righteous put forth his hand into iniquity. Do good, O Lord, unto those that be good, and to them that are upright in their hearts. For such as turn aside unto their crooked way, the Lord shall lead them forth with the Lord shall lead them forth with the workers of iniquity, but peace shall be upon Israel. Psalm 121. When the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that drinks. Then was our mouth filled with laughter and tongue with singing. Then said they among the heathen, the Lord hath done great things for them. The Lord hath done great things for us, wherefore we are glad. Turn again our captivity, O Lord, as the stream in the south. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. They that goeth forth with weeping shall be. They that goeth forth and weeping, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his shield with him. Can I go on?
You can till the time you get there. That's 127 now.
127?
Yeah.
As you finish 27 and stop.
Okay.
I'm asking, where should I stop?
No, you can read to the time you get tired, because we must finish the whole Psalms just as we've been instructed.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Psalm 127. Except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman watcheth but in vain. It is in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows. For so he giveth his beloved sleep. Lo, children are heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. As sorrows are in the hand of a mighty man, so are children of the youth. Happy is the man that had his quiver filled with them. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemies in the gates. 128. Blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord, that walketh in his ways, for thou shalt eat the labor of thy hands. Happy shalt thou be, and it shall be well with thee. Thy wife shall be a fruitful vine by the side of thy house, and the children like olive plants round about your table. Behold, that thus shall the man be blessed that fear the Lord. The Lord shall bless thee out of Zion, and thou shalt see the good of Jerusalem all the days of thy life. Yea, thou shalt see thy children's children, and peace upon Israel. 129. Many a time have they afflicted me from my youth. May Israel now say, many a time have they afflicted me from my youth, yet they have not prevailed against me. The plover plunged upon my back. The plover plunged upon my back, and they made long their furrows. The Lord is righteous. He hath cut asunder the cause of the wicked. Let them all be confounded and turned back that hate Zion. Let them be as grass upon the housetop, which withereth afore it groweth. Wherewith the mower filleth not his hand, nor he that bindeth shield his bosom. Neither do they which go by, saying, The Lord be upon you. You will bless you in the name of the Lord. 130. Out of the depths have I cried unto thee, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let thy ears be attentive to my voice and my supplications. If thou, Lord, shouldest mark iniquity, O Lord, who shall stand? But there is forgiveness with thee, that thou mayest be feared. I wait for the Lord, my soul doth wait, and in his word do I hope. My soul waited for the Lord more than they that watch for the morning. I say, for more now, they that watch for the morning, let Israel hope in the Lord. For with the Lord there is no mercy, and with him is plenteous redemption. And he shall redeem Israel from all his iniquities. 131. Lord, my heart is not haughty, nor my eyes lofty, neither do I excite myself in great matters, or in things too high for me. Surely I have behaved and bequieted myself, and as a child that is weaned of his mother. Okay. My soul is even as a weaned child. Let Israel hope in the Lord, and henceforth and forever. My voice is not coming out fine.
It's coming out. Thank you. Thank you very much, dear sister. You have read the.
Thank you.
You have read about 11 chapters for us. Thank you. Do you have any other thing to contribute?
Thank you, sir. Yes, I just want to say, dear friends, you just pray and wait on the Lord, for our Lord is faithful. He said, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. All dear friends, you just hope in the Lord. So we look up unto the hills, the help that the help for dear friends are not going to come from the hills. So we look up unto the hills, but our help definitely is coming from Chukwukike Abiama, who made the heavens and the earth. He said, he that keepeth Israel is not going to slumber nor sleep. He that watcheth over Biafrans will never slumber nor sleep. The enemies we are seeing today all over Biafra land, the Janjaweed, Boko Haram terrorists, Fulani herdsmen, the paramilitary, and every one of them, you know, occupying Biafra land now, you know, where they hope that they are going to wipe us all out and take over our land. Those enemies we are seeing today, our Lord Chukwukike Abiama is going to raise the weapon of warfare and take care of them, like he did to the Egyptians. Exactly what is going to happen to those people. They are not going to go the same way they came. The land of Biafra is going to open up and swallow each and every one of them. That at the end of the day, Biafra is going to come, because Biafra is the kingdom of God on earth. And there is nothing any human can do to stop it. We are going home, and that is the way it remains. Whether the Fulani or anybody likes it or not, we are going back to our land, the land of the rising sun. So I just want all Biafrans to hope in Chukwukike Abiama, because he's faithful, he's reliable, he's dependable, he's the God that cannot lie, he's the God that cannot change. He remained the same forever. What he says he will do, he will do. He has promised us the land of the rising sun, and that is the way it's going to be. Our Biafra will come, and so shall it be, in the name of Chukwukike Abiama. Thank you.
Thank you very much, my dear sister. It seems you are a minister. Thank you very much for your contribution. Thank you. Really appreciate what you are doing for the restoration of Biafra. That's our sister all the way from Canada, Sister Ebele. Thank you very much for coming and for the reading of the Psalms. This is Radio Biafra Hausa Service 2 coming to you from the platform of Radio Biafra London. It's like one of us is here with me. Mazianene, can you hear me? Mazianene, can you hear me? Mazi, can you hear me? Mazianene. Seems the line is not clear. Since the line is not clear, we must continue. You can call in for the continuation of the reading of the Psalms with this number, +1 832 63 73 499. This is Radio Biafra Hausa Service 2 coming to you from the platform of Radio Biafra London. This is the time for us to do the needful thing. What we were asked to do spiritually for the coming of our dear land Biafra. Next caller, tell us your name and where you are calling from. Caller, can you tell us your name and where you are calling from? Good morning, my dear brother.
My name is Mbadiwe.
Oh, Maz Mbadiwe, you are highly welcome.
I hail from Oji River Province. I'm calling from Johor, Malaysia. IPOB.
You are highly welcome, my dear brother. One of the hard call.
Once again, good morning, everybody. Good afternoon, everybody. Good evening and good night, everybody. Malaysia, it is already morning here. This is some minutes to 11 a.m. here. Nwachineke, once again, which of the Psalms, is it 129 or 130? 129, where did the last one stop?
Our sister finished Psalm 130.
130, that's okay.
So yeah, you start 131, 132, 133. But before you go on, who is your hero?
Well, I have many of them my heroes. I have many of them because the people that fought and wanted to rescue us.
You remember those days? Maybe, let me come in a bit, sir. You remember those days? Maybe you were born and brought up in Catholic. I don't know your faith now. But that time we used to say, send this and that, pray for us. Send this and that. I don't know whether you really study about those saints. Because I let that take my time, studies one or two of them. I noticed that these are people who went for war. They fought for the freedom of their people. And with the order of Constantine and other things, they were canonized. They were canonized to be a holy people. That is their doctrine. I'm not against the doctrine. But for me to be part of the people that say, so person, pray for me, whereby I have my own that lay his life, that I will be. In fact, that is the highest saint for me. And that is why I made it a must here that before you call in today, tomorrow, one must mention one or two of all these our heroes that you know, you love, you prefer, so you want to follow his way before you proceed. You have the mic, sir.
Yes, I have many of them as my heroes, like Lieutenant Colonel Ike Okoro. I have Major J.I.U.D.N.U. And I have Major D.O. Okafo. Even Okafo was 12 years when this war started. It was 12 years when this war started. And when it started, many of them, they went to the radio to listen, to know the next line of action. And suddenly there were explosives, you know. And these people, looking at the love they have for the country, at the age of 12, these people, you know, especially this guy, he didn't fear his life. He went in to rescue his people. Unlike what we have today, which is really, really, really appalling. So that is just the whole thing, to have given their life that we may live is worth celebrating and canonizing, because they did what they did. What they did has enabled us to still remain in that part of our, that's in our land today. Unlike Israel, look at Israel. Israel was destroyed in 70 AD. And after some time, British came in to occupy the whole of Israel, Lebanon, and Jordan, and call it Palestine. So you see now that Israel disappeared from the map of the world. But today, Israel had recovered most of their land. We are quite different, that we are still in our land. We have not been destroyed. And there is need. Community comes out of this calamity so that we retain our land as it was. We have been there. We have to see that it is the blessing, it is the protection of the Almighty, that our enemies have not ejected us and rename our land. So the action, the labors of our heroes is the reason we are still there today. And as a result, all hands should be on deck to fight and see that our enemies from nowhere come in to displace us. It will be a shame. But as long as the Almighty Yahweh Elohim liveth, I can remember he destroyed many nations through the Gideon using only 30 soldiers. So in terms of the Almighty, he does not require multitudes.
and I have seen in history that multitude never fight for him. He will always achieve whatever he wants to achieve using minority. And in the same way, we have heard Onyendu talk of 100 soldiers only. When we have the courage and determination and not to walk like the 12 spies who went and saw empty people because they were very huge, they thought that these people will overcome them without knowing that one with the Almighty is always majority and the person will conquer. Nwachineke, at this junction, I want to start reading from the book of Psalm. Like I said 2 days ago, Book of Psalm is a wonderful book in the scripture.
Yeah, you can, sir.
And I brought last time that this is a good opportunity for many people, because I know that many of us don't even know that Book of Psalm is in the scripture. Book of Psalm contains 3 levels of information. It has spiritual songs. We have to understand what is spiritual songs. It has messianic prophecy, and it has spiritual messages. It will be a nice time that many people will read the 150 chapters within a week. It is amazing. It is beautiful. So, Nwachineke, at this point, let me start reading from Psalm 131. I'm reading from Holy Name Bible version. There are so many versions of the scripture. There are about 4,250 versions. I'm reading from Holy Name Bible. My heart is not proud, O Yahweh. My eyes are not haughty. I do not concern myself with great matters or things too wonderful for me. But I have stilled and whetted my soul like a weaned child with his mother. Like a weaned child is my soul within me. Oh, Biafra, put your hope in Yahweh. For now, both now and forevermore. 132. Oh, Yahweh, remember Mazi Nnamdi Kanu for all the hardships he endures and still enduring. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu has won an oath to Yahweh Elohim and made vow to the mighty one of heaven. He will not enter into a house or go to his bed, or will he allow no sleep in the eyes, no slumber to his eyelids, till he finds a place for Yahweh, a dwelling for the mighty one of heaven. We had it in many places of Biafra land. We came upon it in the field of Jah. Let us go to the dwelling place. Let us worship at his footstool. Arise, O Yahweh Elohim, and come to your resting place, which Mazi Nnamdi Kanu has promised he will build for you when Biafra is restored. You and the ark of your might. May your priests be clothed with righteousness. Hello?
Yeah, I'm with you, sir. Carry on.
May your priest be clothed with righteousness. May your saints sing for joy. All that are laboring with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, may they sing for joy. For the sake of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, your servant, do not reject your anointed one. Yahweh Elohim swore an oath to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, a sure oath that he will not revoke. He will restore Biafra nation. One of your own descendants he will place on your throne if your son keep my covenant. Here we have to enjoy all Biafra to keep the covenant of Yahweh. It starts with 10 commandments. 10 commandments.
come 10 commandments. I think I want to, at this junction, demand something. I want everybody, maybe at the end of this Heroes Day, to look at 10 commandments themselves in Exodus chapter 20. Many people can say it in Igbo, but what they say in Igbo are not quoted in the 10 commandments. What they say in Igbo, what they saying in Igbo, what they say in Igbo, they are different from what is in 10 commandments written in Exodus chapter 20. Because I noticed that the one they state in Igbo, they omit the second commandment. They omit it. They omit it. And at the end, the tenth one, they divide it into two. They divide it into two. So what they call the third commandment is not the third commandment. What they call the fourth commandment is not the so. I want to demand every Biafran. Because we have to understand that it was mandated that all the Israelites know this before they left Egypt. For your sons, keep your covenant and the statutes Maazi Namdekan teaches them. Then their sons will sit on your throne forever and ever in the temple that we built for Biafra nation. For Yahweh has chosen Biafra, he has desired it for his dwelling. This is his resting place forever and ever. Here he will sit enthroned, for he has desired it. He will bless Biafra with abundant provision, her poor will satisfy with food. He will clothe their priests, their teachers with salvation, and her saints, good Biafran people, will ever sing for joy. Here you will make a new horn, a king, grow for Maazi Namdekan, and set up a lamb for his anointed one. He will clothe his enemies with shame. He will clothe his enemies with shame. He will clothe all the traitors and saboteurs with shame. But the crown on his head will be resplendent. How good and pleasant it is when brethren live together in unity. Community should come out of this calamity and we will unite. It is like precious oil poured on the head running down on the bed, running down on Namdekanu's head as time comes, down upon the collar of his robes. It is as if the dew of Hermon will fall in on the amount of Biafra as he restored. For there Yahweh Elohim bestows his blessing, even life forevermore. Praise Yahweh Elohim, all you servants, all you good IPOB members. Praise Yahweh Elohim, all you good IPOB members, all you good IPOB members of the Most High, who have been working night and day to see the championing of this restoration in order to establish a place that will serve and will worship Almighty. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary and praise Yahweh Elohim. May Yahweh Elohim, the maker of heaven and earth, bless the nation of Biafra. Psalm 135. Praise Yahweh Elohim. Praise the name of Yahweh. Praise Him. IPOB, good IPOB, dedicated IPOB, consistent IPOB members all over the world.
you who are working day and night for the restoration of this kingdom that will later build a sanctuary for Yahweh. And in the course of the house of Yahweh, praise Yahweh. Yahweh Elohim is good. We could continue to sing praises to his holy name, for this is pleasant. For Yahweh has chosen Namdekan to be his own, and nobody will stop it. Like he chose Moses, Moses indeed encountered a lot of opposition within his own household. It was because of the pleading of Moses that Aaron was called in. Aaron happens to be the elder brother of Moses. And we see what Aaron has done. Aaron led Israel to worship a golden image. Just within 7 weeks, before the Almighty gave the Ten Commandments, he directed Moses to inform the Israelites what they are about to hear. And the Israelites responded corporately. Everything Yahweh Elohim said, we will do. The Almighty came down. The Almighty proclaimed the Ten Commandments. And written on 2 tablets of stone, the Almighty later called on Moses, come and collect it. Moses was just there for 40 days and 40 nights. Moses had not even spent 7 weeks. 7 weeks is 49 days. And what came upon Aaron was to lead the people to disobey the second commandment, which forbids making image, which forbids bowing down, which forbids honoring them. It was done by Aaron. And Aaron and Moses are from the same household, the same parent, can you imagine? Even in the wilderness, we saw another thing Miriam did. Miriam is a sister of Moses. So enemy within has been. It is left for us to understand and not always to war with them. And I'm happy with one thing. No matter what the enemy did to Moses, Moses never turned left or right. Moses' mission was straightforward. Like I always tell people, the visioner has it all. There will be distractions on the way, but distraction does not distract the visioner. Just like nothing on earth today has shown to distract Mazi Namdekan. We see his focus. We see he is focused. He is determined, and he is working accordingly. Praise Yahweh, for Yahweh is good. Sing praise to his holy name, for that is pleasant. For Yahweh has chosen Namdekan to be his own. And there's nothing anybody can do. Anybody can do whatever he wants, but anybody who does whatever he wants to do will be put to shame at the end. It just requires us to be courageous, to be like Caleb and the Joshua, and not to be like the 10 stupid spies. For Yahweh has chosen Namdekan to be his own. Nation of Biafra will be his treasured possession. I know that Yahweh is great, for Yahweh Elohim is greater than all other gods. Yahweh does whatever pleases him in the heavens and on the earth, in the sea and in the depths. He makes clouds rise from the ends of the earth. He sends lightning with the rain and brings out the winds from his storehouses. He struck down the firstborn of Egypt,
He struck down the firstborn of Egypt, and he will strike down all the firstborn of all the enemies of Biafra in Nigeria, in Biafra land, all the saboteurs, all the traitors, all the saboteurs, all the enemies within and outside. They will all be struck. We are going to see many of them dying like flies in the days ahead, in the mighty name of Yahweh Elohim.
He said.
He sent signs and wonders into their midst. Just like we see now, he sent signs. But the thing is that the enemies can never understand. The enemies can never understand. And that is why they will continue to die and be dying in shame. He struck down many nations and killed many mighty ones. We can see now that many of the so-called statesmen, many of them in Zoo, they are just dying in Kano, in Kaduna, in Sokoto, and so it will continue. Because in the Almighty's economy, he might use enemies to punish his people, but at the end, he will turn around and destroy that enemies. This has been his economy from the creation. Psalm 135, verse 13. You are no more Yahweh and yours forever. You are renowned, O Yahweh, throughout all generation. For Yahweh will vindicate his people and have compassion on his servants. The idols of the nations are silver and gold, molded objects, molded clays. And they will fashion all these things and believe that it is God. Objects that don't talk, objects that don't hear, objects that don't see, shame unto them. They were made by hands, they have mouth, they cannot speak, eyes, they cannot see, ear, they cannot hear, nor is there breath in their mouth. Those who make them will be like them, and so will all who trust in them. O house of Biafra, praise Yahweh. O house of Nnamdi Kanu, praise Yahweh. O houses of the members of DOS, praise Yahweh. All the principal officers, praise Yahweh. All the broadcasters who labor night and day, praise Yahweh. And I want to assure you, our resurrection is close at hand. Very close at hand. And nothing will stop it. Nwachineke, let me say something before I go forward.
All right, you have 2 minutes more.
In the year 605 BC, the Almighty foretold the end of the world. This calendar is in Daniel chapter 2. And many people around the world, 99% of human race, don't even know about this. And the passage of time has been going on. Look, the first kingdom was Kingdom of Babylon. It has come and gone. The second kingdom was Medo-Persia. It has come and gone. The third kingdom was Grecian Empire. It has come and gone. The fourth kingdom was Roman Empire. It has come and gone. Roman Empire was destroyed by the barbarians. And it is created into 10 ethnic nations. That 10 ethnic nations have come and gone. We have little variants today. So from today, if we look at Daniel chapter 2, we are towards the end of the feast. And towards the end of the feast is the time of many kings. It is within this feast we have many kings, and there have been wars and wars and wars, because the old 10 destiny, wars have collapsed many of them, wars have scattered all of them, because it is in the period of this, you know, the feast that we have many. So this is why, it is during this time, in 1948, that nation of Israel was formed, was restored. And within this time of feast, that nation of Biafra will also be restored, and nothing will stop it. It is after the restoration before we can talk of end of the age. Oh, house of Nnamdi Kanu, praise Yahweh. Oh, house of DOS IP members, praise Yahweh. Oh, house and our broadcasters all around the world, praise Yahweh. All the dedicated, committed, consistent, and real Biafrans, praise Yahweh. Praise be to Yahweh Elohim from the coming land of Biafra, which is now just in the air, and it is descending. It will descend in. And to him who dwells in heaven, we dwell in the temple Nnamdi Kanu will build for him when the nation of Biafra is restored. Mazi Nwachineke, I will stop here. Let everybody praise Yahweh.
Thank you very much, our dear brother. I notice you have a lot, and I will advise you every Shabbat day, come up online to lecture your people. I'll try to avail some time for you for that.
Thank you very much.
And may Elohim bless you.
Bless everybody.
Amen. This is Radio Biafra Hausa Service 2 coming to you from the platform of Radio Biafra London. That is our dear brother Mbadiwe, all the way from Johor Bahru, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, and he has contributed his own quota for the preparation of our 30th May celebration. Indeed, it's a very special day for us to remember and to celebrate. These people fought and died for us. These days now, we were asked just to contribute $1. Our people find it very difficult to just to give $1, talk less of paying monthly dues and other things, or attending Biafran meeting. But the people we are talking about are people who lay their life. There is war. They saw people falling, being shot down, but they are still going, moving ahead in order to defend both born and unborn. Some of us were not born as at that time, but they were fighting to defend us. And you were asked to prepare for the celebration, and some of us are thinking or calculating it. But when you are called in some certain denomination or whatever, you kneel down before something and pray for it. Or when you are reading your books in school, they will be quoting some certain people, tell you that this person is a John FN whatever, and you follow the person. You don't even know who that person is, but your own person, your own ancestors that fought for you, you don't want to think about them, who are real, the good people. You don't want to think about them. You don't want to remember them. You are helping the enemy, the people who don't want you to continue to increase. The moment you fuel what they are doing, the moment you remain down. We must continue. Thank you very much, our brother, all the way from Malaysia, for calling. And may the good Lord bless you. May the Almighty Elohim increase you in all you are doing. This is Radio Biafra. He was saying something regarding our freedom. We must remember, just few weeks ago, we just celebrated the Feast of Passover. And the Feast of Passover, we are celebrated in Exodus chapter 12, and Israel were liberated. If you go to Joshua chapter 6, chapter 5, Feast of Passover, we are celebrated, and Israel entered into the promised land. We must understand, on 14th of May 1948, after the Feast of Passover, this present state of Israel for the past 2000 years were as well created. And that is why we are believing God that indeed we, the children of God, we, the Biafrans, this is our time. Believe and God will never say no. A man of God told me, he said, when your faith say yes, God cannot say no. That's my grandfather in the Lord. When your faith say yes, God cannot say no. If we agree spiritually and physically and ready, say this time, this is the time, definitely God will answer us. I will bring in one of our co-presenter all the way from United States in the person of Mazi Anene. Mazi Anene, I don't know if you can hear me. If you can hear me, you are live on air. you can speak to the world.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. You are live on air.
Thank you very much, Mazi. For some reason, this connection, it comes and goes. But thank you very much for the work you do for Biafra. And I thank Mazi Mbadiwe that just finished. He did a wonderful presentation here. And also our sister from Canada. My God bless your soul. You know, to that our sister, it's not just for us that we are fighting. It's for me personally. It's for
Mazianene, hold on. Mazianene, hold on. I know you are one of the co-presenter. Mazianene, can you hear me?
Never we have.
Mazi, can you hear me?
Can you hear me clearly?
Yeah, I said just hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on.
But very faintly.
Just hold on, hold on. The connectivity is somehow. But I want to ask you something. Who is your hero among the fallen heroes? Who is your mentor? Who is your role model? Who are you following? Who is your saint among them? Just as we are doing in those days.
Oh yes.
Let the world know and tell us the reason why you choose the person.
Absolutely. I was coming to that. You know, yes. I wanted to thank our people. Definitely, Mazi. You know, I'm from Nnewi, and Nnewi has doing the work. Pretty much fielded quite a few good men, not to be prejudiced or anything, but someone like Onwatuegbu, before we go to the dead, Mazi. You know, very often we always. From them, but we have some living heroes as well, among whom is Nnamdi Kanu. Because if God didn't send that man, where would we be today? You know, sometimes there's a word that is said in the Bible that a prophet, you know, doesn't really have that much respect in his own house. And Nnamdi Kanu he's a godsend. I don't care what anyone says, you know. He is one hero that is alive that we need to acknowledge, along with deep heroes like Onwuegbu, okay, like Akama Ibiam, like Timonwatu, and a whole lot of others. Some of whom were my family members, my own blood relatives. And we pray to Chineke Chukwuabiamah that he grant endless peace to their souls, because they stood up when they were called and they gave it all so that we would live. They gave it all. They didn't run back. They didn't hide. When they were called, they stood up, and they not only
Mazi, are you there? Mazi Anene, can you hear me?
Your audio has been, from my end, it hasn't been great. It comes and goes. I don't know. I've checked everything. Can you?
No. I can hear you now. Continue. This is Radio Biafra Outside Service 2. We just lost one of our presenters, Mazianene, all the way from United States. I think it's because of the connectivity. We will connect back as soon as possible. This is Radio Biafra. You can call in for the continuation of our program with this number, +1 833 263 73 499. +1 833 263 73 499.
This is Radio Biafra Officer Service 2. Mazenene, can you hear me now?
I can hear you clearly, you know.
Hello, Mazi, can you hear me?
Yes, Mazi, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
All right, you are live on air. You can continue from where you stop. I think it's our connectivity. You are live on air.
Mazi, I can hear you. So, can you hear me?
Loud and clear now. Loud and clear. Continue from where you stop.
Okay. I am so sorry for this. For some reason, every time I tried the phone, I tried the computer. I was saying that we owe a great gratitude to God for blessing us through the person of Nnamdi Kanu. Because if it wasn't for him, who would have raised up the way he did? She is nobody. Who would have risen to really be willing to take every sort of nonsense in the for the betterment of his people? I cannot think of anyone. I can't think of anyone. And even now, I mean, he has seen it all. He has gone through it all. And he keeps going no matter what. Of our people, no matter our I know too much, our envy, our jealousy, our stupidity, he takes it on and he continues to move on. We must thank God for sending him for our own savior. We must thank Chineke, and we owe a great gratitude to God for sending Nnamdi Kanu to rescue us, because nobody else would have.
Mazi, that is the best gift. That is the best gift God has given to us, but most of us don't know. The gift of the life of our leader, Mazi Nnamdi. That is the best. We thought it is money, it is education, it is fame. All these things are nothing. We have it, but we couldn't liberate ourselves. We are not free, nothing. We don't even know our history. We don't know who is who. Who is our brother? If not this man, look at the job he's doing presently now and before. You know, bringing the history, how we related to the people in the River Rhine area, where the enemies have separated us and said all manner of things. This man keep on digging, and we have old men who call themselves elder. They only remember themselves as elder when it comes in sharing. You know, in our Igbo tradition, that is the only place they will remember themselves. But to teach the younger ones the thing that are the basic things of life, the origin of life, where you come from, none of them, we couldn't even hear such a thing. Had it been there as one or two or three or four of them, like our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, from the time the war ended till now, I don't think we'll be having all this loggerhead with our brothers in the river line. At least once in a year, they can a kind of bring out, a kind of festival that they will celebrate the Kiriji, all those kind of thing, you know, to use it to reunite the entire Igbo family, the entire Biafran family together. We'll know who we are. But it was this our leader. That's why I say, let us keep on praying for this man, because it's the best gift Elohim has given to us. Continue, Mazi, you have the mic.
Absolutely. Thank you. Nothing could have been better. No one could have been better. I cannot even express it enough. Because look at us. If not him, then who? Look at us. Just make a mental picture. Who? You know? The so-called elders without wisdom, elders without a sense of belonging, elders without a sense of you know, you can never quantify the value of Nnamdi Kanu. Never, not in our lifetime. He's not only a gift to just Biafrans. He's a gift to the wise ones of the world, the just ones of the world, the good humans of the world. Only the wicked are the ones who are not comfortable. Only the unjust are the ones who are not comfortable. Only the greedy are the ones who will find it uncomfortable because of his presence. And I say, God bless him, God, chineke kaidiaya, pay in there out. He's going in and he's coming out.
He said,
all the days of his life that we are going to enjoy in Biafra.
He said,
and let me use this opportunity to say once again, as I have been saying, especially in the past, first, I will always thank Israel. I will always thank the nation of Israel for the part they played when we had no friend anywhere. We didn't have friends from our neighbors. We didn't have, we had no ally. We were just the ants, the misfits. And even though that Israel was in a war of survival, where enemies were waging war against her, 360 degrees of their surroundings, they were fighting a war of survival. But Israel still found it necessary to extend their helping hand. And for that, I will never forget. And we must never forget. Because they were like a house that shielded the chicken when the rain was pouring. Yes, we lost. The winners won. But we are here today again. Thank God for his blessing also that came in the way of Israel, extending a helping hand to us. And I'm saying again, as I told you in 2013, that they must not sit by the side and let the greedy, the wicked, the unjust, those who say they have interests, come and devour us. Because Israel, you have reason. You should also have interests. And nowhere on this planet can your ships anchor more securely than on the shores of Biafra. I'm saying this again to the Israelis. That blood of Jacob, that blood that is thicker than water, let no enemy even dare come between it. Let no enemy, it must be off limit. You must, don't sit on the sideline. You must come and sit by the table where all of us will gather and thank God and we have good dinner. You have come of age. And we thank God. Blood is thicker than water. That's not something that we made up. That's an adage that's been in existence before our fathers were even born. It's unfortunate that we have so many detractors, but Mazi, that's always how it works. I've said this over and over again. But these things are the things we have to fix in our course of getting Biafra. That's a, you know, let's let our people not be dismayed, because so it was in Russia in the days of Lenin. It has always taken a few. So the few of us that are committed to getting Biafra, or we die getting Biafra, must always remember, it has always taken a few. The same goes again, that many are called but few are chosen. It has never changed. It remains true to this day. It will always remain true. Many will be called and only few will be chosen, because it's not everyone that will rise to the occasion. It's not everyone that is equipped to even stand up and rise to the occasion. What would you do with one who's not equipped? That becomes a liability. So we must never be dismayed. In fact, we must, this is the time, as we mourn our dead and pay tribute to them, we must also rejoice for the blessings that Chineke has given us so far. if for nothing else, for keeping Nnamdi Kanu alive to this day. In 2015, the British intelligence, before they concluded their meeting, and sent David Cameron to come and tell Obama that the issue of Biafra is way above his pay grade, so to ensure that he doesn't dabble into it. They said that if Biafra had to come, that it would come without Nnamdi Kanu. Yes. And, I thank God, and we must be thankful to Chineke, and we must always pray. Before we even pray, we must thank Him for having guided us so far, for having guided us so far, for having protected us so far, for having fed us so far. We live amongst wolves threatening to devour us any minute and swallow our bones with nothing left. Even now, as I'm saying this, they are gathering. They are saying to themselves, come, let's go slay them. That we will prove to them that we are God. And I'm telling them, you are not God, because you cannot create something out of nothing. Only God can. And he has. So, we have a lot to be thankful for. And we pray to Chineke to continue to guide us. Mazi, I want to read at least one psalm. Where did...
You have to take from 136.
136?
Yeah, okay. He stopped at 135.
Okay, very well. Let me go through 136 very quickly. If somebody comes, then no problem. Psalm 136, and he goes, give thanks to the Lord, as if I was saying. Here we go. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the God of gods. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord of lords. His love endures forever. To him who alone does great wonders, his love endures forever. Who by his understanding made the heaven, his love endures forever. Who spread out the earth upon the waters, his love endures forever. Who made the great lights, his love endures. The sun to govern the day, his love endures forever. Moon and stars to govern them, to him who struck down the firstborn of Egypt, his love endures forever, and brought Israel out from among them, his love endures forever, with a mighty hand and outstretched arm, his love endures forever, to him who divided the Red Sea asunder, his love endures forever, and brought Israel through the midst of it, his love endures forever, but swept Pharaoh and his army into the Red Sea, his love endures forever, to him who led his people through the desert, his love endures forever, who struck down great kings, and then who struck down great kings, his love endures forever. And killed mighty kings. His love endures forever. Sihon, king of the Amorites. His love endures forever. And Og, king of Bashan. His love endures forever. And gave their land as an inheritance. His love endures forever. An inheritance to his servant Israel. An inheritance to his servant Israel. His love endures forever. To the one who remembered us in our low estate, love endures forever. He freed us from our enemies, love endures forever. He gave his food to
servant yet. He is the God of heaven because his love endures forever. Psalm 136, Martin. And we always give thanks to the Lord, to God. We told Chinek, before we ask him for anything, we must always never forget to thank him for what he has already done. He's more fertile than the land of God. And our enemies, his love for us, so endures forever. Let me also read 138.
You want to read 137.
And it and quite amazingly, say it's the, you know, the psalm that we love. For it goes this way, it says, by the rivers of Babylon we sat and wept when we remembered Zion. Thereon the poplars we hung our harps. For there our captors asked for us sons. Our tormentors demanded the sons of joy. They said, sing us one of the sons of Zion while they are tormenting us. And then we say, how can we sing the Lord's song in a land? How can we sing the Lord's song in a land that is foreign to us? If I forget you, O Jerusalem, may my right hand forget its care. May our tongue cling to the roof of my mouth if I do not remember you. If I do not consider Jerusalem my highest joy. Remember, Lord, what the Edomites did on the day Jerusalem fell. Tear it down, they cried. Tear it down to its foundation. O Jew of Babylon, doomed this. Happy is who repays you for what you have done to us. He who seizes your infants and dashes them against the cross. And remember the song from the best one, the best version of it was one from Bonnie M. By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down and there we wept when we remember Zion. Because when you inherit, when you are no longer in your own land, when you forsake your inheritance for whatever reason, instead of staying there to fight and die and be buried and become a part of the soil that is your inheritance, then caring your value becomes worthless. Lose your value. For we must remember that come what may, it is better that we remain where we belong when it's all said and done. It's always good to be where you belong. If we have to fight and your flesh become soil in the importance that Almighty gave to, rather than die and be buried foreign. And on that, I'm asking again to, yes, we always have detractors. Detractors existed before our forefathers. So you will always have those who will energize you. Sometimes they come in negative ways. So you talk that into something valuable. And it pains me a great deal that if here is and elsewhere around the world hasn't come to realize that the fact that the these people who advance. And then the opportunity we have, better than they do, to now make contributions, because this is exactly why God sent us here. Out of sweet and bad, we must learn to turn it into something good, something that is enduring, and that is something about which we will be remembered when we are no longer here. After all, applaud the names of all the people we remember. Here we are tonight, thanking God for sending the soldiers that to defend us. Those who didn't do anything, do we remember them? We don't. Their names are not mentioned. So these ones that went and fought for us, they will live within us forever. Those are the lives that we must share. And we must be able to build this, the same, the same food for our children and those coming after us. I told those that if this is where you think you got it made, and that's the promise that you're going to give to your children, then you're not thinking. You can't see, you're not thinking far at all. Your view about things are very myopic. Your views are very myopic. Very myopic. You're not seeing. You're not thinking. Be able to look around you as your folder. That's all. Able to tell which seed can grow. So that you know. So that you know. So that you can help us to water. As I see the fetch data, our growth will be touched. And yet our energy will you the worst is I'm asking you, our God, yet to look into the seeds of men, to look into our hearts, and guide us, give us the protection that only you, God, can, in spirit, in the spiritual realm, and guide us through the ones that we have to do ourselves, because in practical times, we have to do the practical ones. You cannot come here and turn into a soldier. Otherwise, why did you give us brains, hands and feet, eyes to see, mouths to talk? I always ask you to guide us through the decisions that we make. Continue to guide man the camp. Give him the energy, the endurance to put up with our stupidity, because it's a normal. Help him carry that weight sometimes. Sometimes carry him himself, so that we see just one file of footprint on the sand, knowing that heavy that you carried him, because it's all we have.
Tomasi, try to round up so that our time is no more on our side.
Yeah. Yes, Maz, I know, I just looked at the time. All in all, I'm asking Chineke to bless us and bless our efforts. Guide our thoughts, guide our efforts.
Yes, sir.
Guide our undertaking.
Yes, sir.
Because my heart, I yearn for us to give our women the respect that they deserve.
Yes, sir.
The protection that they deserve.
Yes, sir.
Oh, God. Guide us, oh God, so that when all is said and done, all glory, all honor, all adoration, everything, we will bow our heads to you in a temple that we will call ours from now till eternity. You see?
Ise. Thank you very much, Maz. Thank you very much for your wonderful contribution. Time is no more on our side, and we will continue. Tomorrow will be very, very wonderful, because tomorrow is the D-Day. A lot of countries will come online as well to hook up with the program. We will continue. Thank you very much, Mazi. Let me take a last call before I round up. Let me take this last call. Call on the line. You just have 2 minutes, because you are a regular caller. That's why I'm picking your call. You just have 2 minutes. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, loud and clear. Very loud and clear.
Very good. Thank you. My name is Elanya Uche. I am calling from New Jersey, USA. And I want to go right into reading Psalm 138. Psalm 138, Thanksgiving and Praise. I'm reading from a Revised Standard Version. I give you thanks, O Lord, with my whole heart. Before the angels, I sing your praise. I bow down toward your holy temple and give thanks to your name for your mercy and your faithfulness. For you have exalted above everything your name and your word. On the day I called, you answered me. My strength of soul you increased. All the kings of the earth shall praise you, O Lord, for they have heard the words of your mouth, and they shall sing of the ways of the Lord. For great is the glory of the Lord. For though the Lord is high, he regards the lowly. But the haughty he knows from afar. Though I walk in the midst of trouble, you preserve my life. You stretch out my hand against the wrath of my enemies, and your right hand delivers me. The Lord will fulfill his purpose for me, O Biafra. Your mercy, O Lord, endures forever. You do not forsake the work of your hands. Psalm 138. Mazi Onyendu. Mazi Nwachineke. This psalm is very clear in what it is saying. In the 7th verse, it says, though I walk in the midst of trouble, you preserve my life. We are surrounded by trouble, but the Lord is promising to preserve Biafra. His purpose for Biafra he will fulfill, he says in the next verse. And he will not forsake the work of his hands. Only God created Biafra. Biafra is the work of God's hands, and he will not forsake us. Mazi Nwachineke, my 2 minutes is up. And I thank you for the time you've afforded me.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, my dear brother. Always call on time. I do like your contribution, but you do call in late. Thank you very much. May the good Lord bless you. This is Radio Biafra London, coming to you from the platform of Radio Biafra London, being deputized by the good man himself, Mazi Uche Mefo, under the leadership of one and only Onyendu Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. And this message is coming to you from me, Nwachineke. Let's just take this call finally before we sign out. Dear Prophet X, if you can hear me, you go on. You have only 2 or 3 minutes.
Okay. Good morning, Nwachineke.
Welcome.
I really thank God for what God has done. So,
you didn't tell us your name and who is your hero. Okay.
My name is Amarachi, and my hero is Nnamdi Kanu, our director, our ego director, and the Uche Mofo. So God has used them to make us, to let us recover. To let us, recover what we have lost for a long time. And for sure, by the special grace of God, Biafra is here with us soon, soonest. So, I really thank God for that. My name is Amarachi. I came from Asaisi, Nupa, local government area, Biafra land, from Abia State. So I would like to read Psalm 140. I'm not going to waste much time.
Just 139. We are moving series by series. 139.
Okay.
That will be the last one. Then tomorrow we'll finish the rest.
Okay. Psalm 139. O Lord, thou hast searched Biafra and know us. Thou knowest our dwell, our down sitting, my our uprising, thou understandest. Our thoughts are far off. Thou compassed by our path and our lying down, and are acquainted with all our ways. For there is not a word in our tongue, but Lord, O Lord, thou knowest it altogether. Thou hast beset us behind and before, and laid thy hand upon Biafra. Such knowledge is too wonderful for us. It's high, and we cannot attain unto it. Whither shall we go from thy spirit? Or whither shall we flee from thy presence? If we ascend up unto heaven, thou art there. If we make our bed in hell, behold, thou art there. If we take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost part of the sea, even there shall thy hand lead Biafra, and thy right hand shall hold us. If we say, surely the darkness shall cover us, even the night shall be light about us, about Biafra. Yea, the darkness hideth not from thee, but the night shineth as the day. The darkness and the light are both alike to thee. For thou hast possessed our realms. Thou hast covered us in our mother's womb. We will praise thee, for we are fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that our soul knoweth right well. Our substance was not hid from thee when we was made in secret and curiously wrought in the lowest part of the earth. Thy eyes did see our substance, yet being unperfect, and in the book all our members were written, which in countenance were fashioned, when as yet there was none of them. How precious also are the thought unto us, O God! How great is the sums of them, longer than the sand. When we were awake, we are still with thee. Surely thou wilt slay the wicked, O God, depart from us, therefore, ye bloody men. Depart from us, therefore, ye bloody men, for these speak against thee wickedly, and thy enemies take thy name in vain. Do not I hate them, O Lord, that hated the Biafra? Do not hate them, O Lord, that hate thee, and will not I grieve with those that rise up against thee? We hate them with perfect hatred. We count them our enemies. We count Nigeria our enemies. Search us, O God, and know our heart. Try us and know our thoughts, and see if there be any wicked. If there be any wicked way in us, and lead us in the way everlasting to everlasting, I pray.
He say. Thank you very much, my dear sister. Because our program is about to end right now. If you check your time, it is almost 5 a.m. Biafra land time, and another person have to take over. Thank you very much, and we continue from here tomorrow. That's our prophet, our prophetess, Amarachi, all the way from France. Thank you very much for the good work you are doing. I thank each and every one of us for the wonderful things we are doing, and I leave you with this word from Psalm 137:5. The Bible said, if I forget you, O Biafra, let my right hand forget how to play the harp. We must not forget Biafra. We must continue. Thank you very much. Time is not on our side, and we will end our program in this way.